You're listening to the number one podcast in all of space and time. Welcome to season six of Give Mike a Mic Reloaded.
Well, hello, hello, my beautiful listeners. Welcome to Give Mike a Mic Reloaded. I'm your host, Michael Vivaldi. And as you can see or hear, I am by myself right now. And that is because we had a little technical malfunction that was on my part. I don't make a lot of mistakes when it comes to the podcast, of course. I'm not playing any clips to negate that fact, so you can just chill out with that. Unfortunately, when we recorded this episode, we went through about 30 minutes or so of content before I realized I did not hit record. So that's why I'm here recording an intro looking the way that I do. I just woke up and then I went in to check out the recording and noticed that it was a lot shorter than I remember. So here we are. I'm going to do my best to recap what we talked about in a very quick fashion so that way we could get into the real meat and potatoes of the podcast, because we love when everybody's all together and we can have that cool little banter. So before we get into it, though, I'm going to do some housekeeping. So as always, make sure you subscribe to this podcast anywhere you listen to your favorite shows, including Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Amazon Music, and more. Make sure you also hit the follow and subscribe buttons. Hit the bell to be the first to get notified of new episodes that are dropping. And please give us that 5-star review on Spotify and Apple Podcasts, because I am a 5-star man. And make sure you also follow us on Instagram at Give Mike a Mic and TikTok, Give Mike a Mic Pod, for all the latest clips. We're going to be starting to upload more content on those networks, so just make sure you're keeping track of that. And make sure you don't forget to share the podcast with all of your lovely friends and family. Also, let us know what you think about the episode and leave us a message, either in our DMs, or you can email us at givemikeamic at gmail.com. Not reloaded. So givemikeamic at gmail.com. All right, now that that's out of the way, again, I'm going to apologize because it's just me right now for the next probably 5 to 10 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and recap what we talked about. Basically, it is myself and Omar and Alex on the podcast. So I would have them introduce themselves, but they already did that off camera. So I'm doing that for them right now. But we did go ahead and see Deadpool and Wolverine. Alex and I saw it together, and Omar saw it, I think, twice already before we went to see it once. So, yeah. But at any rate, we want to talk about Deadpool and Wolverine because that's the most recent movie that has come out. And so we're going to talk about that a little bit here. We're going to get into some of the cameos. I believe we also talked about Wolverine, the costumes, and you know, the endings and what it means for the MCU going forward, including the announcement that was made over that weekend as well at San Diego Comic-Con with Robert Downey Jr. coming back to play Dr. Doom. So there was obviously a lot that happened, so we wanted to get into that. And of course, review the movie, which we did. We talked about, in the beginning, we talked about that you didn't see. We talked about the opening credits, of course. NSYNC, Bye Bye Bye, is now number one on the charts, thankfully, for this to this movie. They also renamed the track officially on YouTube and Spotify, probably Apple Podcasts too, Bye Bye Bye, from the movie or from the film Deadpool and Wolverine. So it's actually on there. It was such a big hit, and it's on number one on the charts again because of this movie. So there we go. The movie itself, and again, this is going to be spoilerific, guys. So if you haven't watched Deadpool and Wolverine yet, please go ahead and run as fast as you can to your local movie theater. I believe Jay, of all people, did not see this movie yet. So I think he's the only one that's missing as far as Deadpool and Wolverine. So Jay, if you're listening, please go ahead and stop this podcast and come back to it at a later time, unless you want to be spoiled, and we'll give you all the spoilers. So once we get past the opening credits here, though, Logan is dead. Deadpool, in the opening credits, we're you know, he's fighting the TVA agents. TVA, if you remember, they're from the show Loki. So they play a part in here as far as like time variance and, you know, messing with time, which Deadpool did do at the end of, I think it was Deadpool 2, that he gets a little time thing from his bracelet from Cable and goes to save Vanessa and kills Deadpool in Wolverine Origins. So there's a lot of things that happen. The plot is that Deadpool is taken by the TVA because he's going crazy and killing TVA agents. And his anchor being as well, they introduced this concept of anchor being. It's basically a person that's very important to the universe that they live in. So in Deadpool's universe, in his world, Logan was actually the anchor being. So when he died, the entire, basically his world and timeline in the TVA is dying as well. So it's no longer going to be a thing. And everyone that Deadpool knows, that Wade Wilson knows, is going to die and disappear. And that's going to be the end of it, right? Deadpool's given a choice by the head of the TVA, or not the head of the TVA, but the bad guy in this TVA story. His name is Paradox. And I think Omar mentioned that he's from Succession. So I guess if you watch Succession, then you'll notice a familiar face on that. I have yet to watch it yet, but we'll get to that at some point. So the bad guy tells Deadpool, he's like, hey, you can either go back to your world and die with your friends, or you could come here to the TVA and work for us and help us prune timelines and all this stuff. So the bad guy's motivation is that things change at the TVA since Loki season 2, and Loki sacrificed himself, and now he's like a giant tree holding the timelines together. And this guy doesn't like it. Paradox doesn't like it. He's like, I don't like how the TVA has been running itself. And I remember the Wild West of the TVA, and that's what he wants to go back to. So he tells Deadpool, he's like, hey, go save your friends, go die with your friends, or, you know, save other places. But Deadpool doesn't take that lightly. He's like, I'll find another anchor being. I'll find another Wolverine. And so we have a Wolverine montage that happens, and Wolverine is in different forms as Deadpool goes through different timelines. He has like I forgot what they call the pack, the time pack or whatever it's called. And he goes to different universes, multiverses, I would say, to find a Wolverine to bring back. And he does that. He finds one that's drunk at a bar and has lost everybody that he loved. So it's kind of like a tragic, you know, little backstory. But before he gets to him, he runs into a few other Wolverines, which include many variants from different comic books and the covers. We get one that is like in a brown old school Wolverine outfit. That is fighting the Hulk, Green Hulk. So we get a little Hulk cameo in there. And then the biggest cameo is that we see a Wolverine with his back turned to Deadpool, and then turns around to reveal that it's Henry Cavill. If you know Henry Cavill, he's in a lot of movies, but mostly known for his role as Superman in Man of Steel, Batman vs. Superman, Justice League, like you name it, whatever he was in back then. And Deadpool welcomes him and says, we'll treat you so much better than those guys across the street. So a little fun cameo there, and fun with Henry Cavill there. So anyways, he takes this new Wolverine that he found and takes him back to the TVA and says, hey, this is my new anchor being, so let's save my world. But instead, they're pruned, which, if you remember what the pruning thing was, they have those sticks at the TVA that sends them to basically a garbage dump. And they end up dropping into this garbage dump. It's called the Void. And in the Void, they find a lot of different characters. We're getting a lot of cameos at this point. We have Pyro from X-Men that shows up from the original X-Men movies. Toad. I forgot what this guy's name. He's like Nightcrawler, but red. And then Sabretooth as well. And so Wolverine and Sabretooth have a good fight. And they fight it out, duke it out. Nice little throwback to like the original X-Men movie. And then Chris Evans, of all people, is one of the biggest cameos, if not the biggest cameos, in the movie itself. And he returns not as Captain America, but as his first character in the MCU, Johnny Storm. If you remember the Fantastic Four with Jessica Alba and the dude from The Shield as the Thing, and, you know, Doctor Doom, all that stuff. Chris Evans got his start there in the MCU as Johnny Storm. So he plays a variant of Johnny Storm, or the Johnny Storm from that universe, who is now stuck in the void. And they are sent through this road of, it's kind of like Fury Road, I call it, in the void, kind of like Mad Max. And we meet our head villain, I would say, is Cassandra Nova. I didn't know much about her, especially from the comics and all that, but she was insanely strong and ripped the skin off Chris Evans in a matter of 1.2 seconds. So, yeah, she is basically Charles Xavier's twin that was sent to the void for either killing Charles Xavier or attempting to kill. Because I know she said something, she was in the womb and tried to choke him out with the umbilical cord or something like that. Something dark. I was like, all right, cool. This person has some weird shit to work through. And then she also has the same kind of like mind reading ability that Charles Xavier has. Professor X, if you know him from the X-Men, where you could read the thoughts. But for her, she actually has to make physical contact with the person she's trying to enter their thoughts in. And by doing this, she enters through the back of the head with her hands, and then it goes all the way through, kind of like, looks like a face hugger from Alien. And you have like fingers and stuff coming through the eyeballs of the person and the nostrils. Doesn't hurt them for some reason, but it just feels weird. So that's what she does. That's her power. And she finds Wolverine, the Wolverine that was brought with Deadpool, and says, hey, I've never had a Wolverine come down here before and into the void, and I would love a Wolverine for my posse. And that's what she wants. She wants Wolverine to be part of her gang of thugs down there. So they keep on going and they fight, and they're like, hey, we got to find some people to help us to defeat Cassandra Nova. So on the way, they actually run into Handsome Pool, which is Ryan Reynolds without the mask and a long flowy samurai hairstyle, and he has a companion with him, is Dogpool. Dogpool was probably one of my favorite parts of the movie, because it's, you know, it's a dog, it's an ugly dog, but Deadpool loves him nonetheless, and I'm here for it. So on the way, they find Dogpool, and then there's this big fight in a Honda Odyssey that Wolverine and Deadpool get into, to the tune of Grease, You're the One That I Want. And we also get a special like 1 second clip of The Greatest Showman in that I did not hear, but Omar swears was in there. So on my second view, I'll keep a listen to it. But at any rate, they fight in the Honda Odyssey because Wolverine talks shit, and Wolverine tells Deadpool like, you're nothing and your family's nothing and all this stuff. And then they have this epic fight in the Honda Odyssey. And then we have a lot more cameos to get into, but this is where we catch up with the rest of our podcasters. So I'm going to hand it over to Michael, Omar, and Alex at this time.
Hey, you didn't, I don't know if you mentioned, but the smoke from the Loki show. What's his name? Elias?
Elias from or episode something. Episode 5, yeah.
Chapter whatever, season 1. That's the smoke they brought that back. That's the smoke that was after Wolverine, Deadpool. And that's why they had to disappear far away from everything.
So that's why they had to disappear. And then they're actually going into the Honda Odyssey. They met Deadpool and Handsome Pool. And then once they get to that fight, they start finding people who can help defeat Cassandra Nova, or at least help them get home. And then this is where all these
the rebels
wonderful cameos happen that we talked about a little bit earlier. We have Elektra that shows up, played by Jennifer Garner, who is in Daredevil.
Pause.
Go.
I need to pause you because then I'm going to have to pause you later. What? They had a joke right there with Elektra. Why did they didn't use it? They have so much money for licenses with music and all that. And you're telling me Ryan Reynolds did not think about this? Elektra shows up, right, to his movie. The way they brought her back was so anticlimactic.
Oh, did you want them to play like Evanescence or something?
Yes! You're telling me. Thank you. You're laughing. Everybody I tell this, they're like, oh my God, it's so funny. So dude, imagine, Alex, imagine this guy waking up, and then in the shadows, you see like, wake me up. And she's training and hitting this back, and you're like, And she's like, what the hell is going on here? Where am I?
I think you would have popped for that. You would have had a wet freaking dream, bro.
A bunch of people would have popped. Oh, it's a joke.
I'm saying our generation of love for Evanescence is like way higher to where.
Oh, no. I mean, we have the, of course.
Honestly, you're thinking of a different song than I am. You're thinking about the Wake Me Up Inside. I'm thinking about the one where they're outside in the rain. And I'm so tired of being.
If she walked in, that's a different scene, Poppy. No.
I'm saying if she walked in, like, and it's raining outside,
crying or whatever. About the different song, my immortal.
Yeah.
No. I'm thinking of this song where her training, which I'm sure you guys remember, hitting the backs of Daredevil.
Yeah.
It's become a meme over the years on YouTube because it's so over the top the way she's doing everything, the training. Plus, they do that reference of, oh, I'm sorry, Daredevil died. She goes, I don't care. It played out so well. I'm like, why you guys didn't film a cool intro to Elektra, at least for the intros of the cameos? Everybody else, whatever.
They probably ran out of time, or
something happened. That would have been so chef kiss, but whatever. Go on. That was just a little small gripe there.
No, I think Elektra, they all have the same kind of like introduction. They all came through the same door.
They just
kind of
just walk in
slow motion. So you had Elektra, then you had Blade, who was played by
Skinny Blade,
by not what's his name, not Marshall Ali, but by Wesley
Snipes, the only OG.
Which he made a reference to that too, like he's the only one or something like that. I'm like, no, you're not. Yes, there's one more.
now go pay your taxes.
Then we stop evading your taxes, bitch. Then we had Gambit, who shows up in a wonderful moment, because we know what happened to Gambit in X-Men 97, so it's nice to see
Gambit, man. It's awesome.
Channing Tatum, which a lot of people were confused about, but honestly, if you had followed about Channing Tatum like years ago, around the same time like Deadpool was being worked on and talked about, Gambit was also a superhero that they were talking about doing like a solo movie for, bringing him to like the big screen for that. Outside of X-Men, was it Origins?
X-Men Origins, and they had Gambit. He had a picture with James McAvoy and all that. It was gonna be part of that family.
Well,
everything was ready to go, and then Disney bought freaking Fox.
No, but they had Gambit in, I think it was Origins.
Oh, no. You're talking about the original Gambit. No, that's a different Gambit. Yeah. No. But then Channing Tatum came after that.
Yeah. And they didn't even have Gambit, I don't think, in like the original X-Men movies or First Class.
No,
either.
They didn't have it. No. It
wasn't
which is weird. He's super popular.
And what?
What they did?
Not in the. I think it was X-Men. It was one of the Wolverine ones.
Origins.
Yeah, that's what we say. Origins. Oh, Origins. Yeah. No, it was the crappy, bro. No. It's terrible.
Yeah. But at least he had more of a freaking Cajun accent than.
That accent was ridiculous, bro.
But it was. I think that was part of the joke, though. Right?
Because Deadpool was like,
of course,
who's your dialect coach? Stop! Like, what are you saying?
It was ridiculous.
The best part is when he comes out and he's like, I'm going to make a name for myself, or however the fuck he says it. Like,
you know how long I've been waiting for this? Ooh, I'm about to make a name for myself,
yeah. We're going to talk about this for days to come, but the way he says it is just so fucking bad. Like, it's the worst.
It was ridiculous. I love it.
Bro, it was basically Channing Tatum Jump Street playing Gambit. That's what it was.
My name is Jeff.
Like, even the way he was talking, it's like, I shut up my daddy's dick or whatever to my mom's pussy. Whatever. I'm like, what? Like, what? Like, Gambit doesn't talk like that. But I laugh because it's Deadpool.
Yeah.
You know? But it is what it is. I like it.
Then our last cameo we had was from X-23 / Lara.
That was sweet.
Who was played by Daphne Keane, of course. We love Daphne Keane. Did not know she was 19 years old. She's very young. I don't know how old she was when she did Logan, but I didn't think she was that young.
Like,
but
five.
Apparently, yeah, she was like, she was under 15. So definitely under 12, I think. So that's crazy. So we had her, and she's the reason that Deadpool and Wolverine, I guess, were sent to her because everybody was sent to her for some reason. What was Omar? You seen it twice. Do you know why she sent for them? Or
you mean hold on. You mean why Daphne went to grab Logan?
I think she just gathered them when they were pruned, like when they were, you know, put into that universe.
Put in the void, yeah.
She brought them together as a team. It wasn't like she asked for them to come there type of thing. It was more like she just gathered them together because they were all like the forgotten people, but they were still good guys essentially.
Yeah, like the island.
What I don't like is that they don't really explain why after all that we saw with Logan in the Logan movie, just to know that character X-23, she was pruned to the, you know, to that world. Like I don't understand why we should be pruned. You know what I'm saying? Like
that was one of the.
She's not canceled.
That was one of the things that I talked to Michael about, and I was like kind of confused because they were saying how if your anchor being dies, then your timeline.
Which is Logan, I guess, Wolverine.
But this Logan that we're known to believe is Deadpool's universe, mm-hmm. but then this Daphne is the same Daphne or X-23.
Yeah.
So there was no explanation there really for me. Like, I don't know. Maybe I have to see it again.
Movie, bro. Just go with it.
No, And that's the thing is, yeah. there's so many good elements that like if I have to be from a critic's perspective, sure. that would be the area that I would say there's a little bit of a tightening up that I would say could have happened there. But
I agree.
But at the end of the day, I was happy to see her, especially after her being an Acolyte and how shitty that show was. I'm glad that she was able to come back here and be redeemed because, yeah, that show was bad.
Oh, wasn't she supposed to be like a bad girl in that show?
No, she's actually one of the Jedis or whatever. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So she's like...
I did see on her Instagram, she was like training, like doing like lightsaber training and stuff like that. So I figured she was like a Jedi.
That's like her, good. Her good fight her. Choreography in the show is cool and all that, but her character just is boring. But that's a
garbage,
whole other...
But that's not her fault. That's just the freaking writing.
The writing, yeah.
But in that, you know, you also get the moments between her and, even though it's a variant of Logan, her and Wolverine, like seeing her and Hugh Jackman, like on the screen again, it kind of brought like those emotions obviously back, where it's like, yeah, you're my Logan, or you're Logan, you're a variant, but you were never the person, you were never like the hero and stuff like that. She was giving him this talk about like her Logan, like you remind me of him and stuff like that. And that's like her dad, you know, that's basically her dad. Like imagine that's like a variant of your dad there. So it's like, yeah. you know, give you that moment.
That must be weird for her.
It's weird.
But yeah,
it's
sure.
weird. But you know, really she's been there for a while. So she's probably over
she's
it.
Playing it cool.
Playing it cool, man. And then we get more of a, obviously like Wolverine's dark past that he reveals, you know, that the X-Men were basically all murdered in the mansion. And
I wish we would have saw the old man. I feel like some things were cut, or like you said, no time to film it or whatever.
Yeah, but the whole thing Damn with it. Yeah with him in the comics again with like Mysterio, it would have been great to see like Jake Gyllenhaal like come back as a variant of some type, you know, and like have control Dude, over like, that Logan.
I was expecting like James McAvoy. Well, like, that too. I was expecting yeah. some other cameos, bro. Like they having so many X-Men. Bad guys in this movie and no X-Men.
Yeah,
it was weird.
And imagine,
like, I'm like, come on,
imagine
guys.
Even if they
there
showed
is X-Men, it's Wolverine is an X-Men.
Well, I mean,
come on, more X-Men,
you know
bro.
What I mean?
More
like,
X-Men.
I mean, like his.
Yeah,
people,
but then
give me more.
My problem would be then I feel like it would be too
crowded.
Much. Yeah, too crowded in terms of giving people enough time to actually, you know, breathe and.
Well,
do.
Not that we Maybe. Say we need him as a character, like a main character, but just like. Maybe some type of cameo in like a flashback. You know what I'm saying? Where
I was
like,
thinking like
yeah.
some kind of flashback battle, like yeah. at least like a battle, because that way a lot of fans were expecting it. Not only because hello, it's an X-Men movie, you know, with the Wolverine coming back. There was a long time, I'm sure you heard of it, Alex, that they were rumoring that Halle Berry was going to be in this movie and she was geared up and all that, haircut and stuff. James Madsen was going to be in as well with the old school Cyclops costume, and we never seen that like ever. So I honestly thought they were going to do some kind of flashback when they had like a battle going on. So
but
we
that's
can,
what I'm actual, saying. That would have been the that would have been the time is when they were showing a flashback of him actually like killing all the bad guys that are attacking the X-Men, and then if they were there in the mansion, you know, like when he goes back with Cassandra Nova when she's in his head at some point. And then
No, I understand what you're saying.
That would have been the point to show them. There would have been no other time in the movie that would have
no,
made sense.
No, of course. They screwed that would have been the point. And it would have been cool to have like at least like a 3-4 minute scene with the cameos. That's a cameo, whatever. But it would have been nice to see him with Jean Grey, with Cyclops, because they do mention them with Beast.
And only that, them. Let's just say like they're showing him like fighting all these bad guys and stuff like that. And then he goes to stab one of them. And let's just say like at that point, Mysterio uncovers what's happening Mysterio. And he's stabbing actually Charles. Like he's like face to face with Charles, you know, like James, that James moment, McAvoy. McAvoy, yeah. Oh. Like that would have been like.
That would have been so emotional.
And then just see everybody else just laying down, bro, like Storm and everybody.
When he gets, Logan gets emotional to Cassandra Nova and he says he would have loved you or whatever. He would have buried a hole to find you or whatever. He gets emotional. That hits harder because he freaking like, I murder him.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, no.
It's not like that. That would have been great to add.
There you go. That's just the small things, man.
But it is. Yeah, it's a little small thing. It is what it is. But one of the good things that they did with this movie, too, is Wolverine. We've been wanting to see him in his costume, his classic yellow and blue. Not only with and without the mask. You know, he has the mask on, too. But, I mean, that costume was phenomenal. I don't know how you guys felt about that. But seeing that's honestly the first time we've seen him outside of like a wife beater most of the time, or in like those leather jackets, the helicopter suits that he was wearing with the other X-Men. That made no sense. That was more like X-Men. Yeah. What's that? Evolution? Was that the name of the show?
Yeah.
That's how their costumes used to be.
What Evolution? What is that?
X-Men Evolution, the cartoon animated.
So like the original
show?
Movie.
Oh, the cartoons?
The OG movies. He's saying that those suits look like.
Yeah, they're like old black suits.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was Evolution. From that Evolution. It looked dumb. So now we have him in the full outfit. I mean, Deadpool's outfit, to be honest, from Deadpool 1,
they made it
2,
even better.
3,
I mean, it
looks
more comic book accurate in this movie. Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, yeah, they've always done a great job with like Deadpool's outfits since like the first movie. So to see it kind of come full circle with Wolverine to have his outfit.
Yeah.
I loved it. Like, I loved his outfit. Loved how it looked.
I think honestly, as a fan, it worked now. As a fan back then, I don't think it would have worked. I don't think they would have.
We were not
the
ready for that 20 years ago.
No, I don't think it would have looked good. Like if I'm thinking back to these movies,
you're right.
Like it would have been cool to see it back then, but I feel like this, like the amount of time it took to get there, just made it that much more special. Like especially when he puts it on, like the whole cowl and everything, then you're like, oh shit.
Not only that, there was also CG in there. Back then we had no CG for that.
Oh, it CG, like, and then also you had honestly it was before the MCU, so they had no plans for like superhero movies. They were just making these movies like at that point they had what, the Punisher, Daredevil. They didn't care. They're like, oh, yeah, shit, just put whatever costume on them. It doesn't matter. Like even redo something if you want, just do whatever. A leather, as long as they're like wearing leather, that's all that matters.
It had to be leather. It had to be leather.
That was it. But like later on, obviously, when they know like how big the MCU is and now how big that comic book fans like Alex and stuff like that are going to critique this, that's when they need to up their game and be like, all right, we need to give them the OG costume, classic yellow and blue. And give them a mask.
It took a while to get there.
And even the wife beater and the bomber jacket is still somewhat accurate to the comics and the cartoons a little bit.
Yeah.
So
after a while,
that was like, I feel like that was their way of getting by it without
close
going
to the comics.
Full in. So, but it was an amazing moment for sure.
I'm not gonna lie. I was the annoying guy in the theater that freaking spoiled the crap for everybody by accident. Because did you know he had the cowl like in the back the whole time? Do you know he was going to put on that? I had a feeling he was going to put it on.
I knew he was going to put it on at some point. Yeah, of course.
Exactly. So, Mike, I was waiting for a moment, just a moment, when they walk in slow motion with Madonna. Yeah, yeah. And then they stop and he starts doing this. Mm-hmm. I freaking lost it in the theater and I went, oh my God, here it comes! Here it comes! Bro, the whole audience started, like that, dude, everyone started clapping. Like they knew it was coming. And he starts doing this. And dude, the whole theater lost it. Like I said that, and they went whoop, and everyone just started laughing and clapping because I couldn't hold it. I was like, oh my God, there it is! Like I was waiting for that because I knew it was coming, but I wasn't sure it was gonna be there. Honestly, I wasn't sure anymore.
Yeah,
because it was the whole movie. I'm like, when is it gonna put it on? When is it gonna put it on? What's going on here, guys?
I'm just glad it was like longer than, you know, like 2 minutes. Like he wore
it
for
super
pretty
long.
Good amount of time. Yeah,
it was exactly. The whole fight scene, which I know we kind of skipping around, but that fight scene with the Deadpool's mic, which by the way, it felt like a 2D beat 'em up with a double dragon. You know, the camera, the way it was moving, I was laughing so hard. Beautiful, by the way, just gorgeously shot. And after that, when they go down to the silver looking level, whatever they went to, he was still wearing it. Oh, the way he was moving around, kind of doing that whole like Mortal Kombat looking character, like the way he was behaving.
They even made a
now.
Joke about how he could wear it and move his head, unlike you know, like
he made
DC,
the joke
like,
on Batman. That was great.
Yeah.
And at the end, bro, when they played the orchestra song of Madonna and the whole thing explodes, bro, and he's still wearing that mask. It's that imagery, man. That's going to haunt me for a while in a good way. You know, I just loved it.
Oh, what dreams?
Yeah.
Right before that reveal that he puts his mask on, you have a really cool scene that's basically just 100 Deadpools that decided to show up at once. You have a couple, out of nowhere.
Bad guys now, boy.
You have Lady Deadpool who's leading the charge on that.
Do you know who that was, by the way?
That is Blake Lively, who is Ryan Reynolds' wife in real life. So
awesome. And the cowboy, you know who it was?
The cowboy, I do not know who that was.
Oh, I thought you knew. What's his face?
Interstellar. I think I saw a post.
Matthew McConaughey?
Yeah.
Oh shit. Okay.
And the head, the talking head, that's Nathan Fillion.
Okay. He's in
a lot.
They
have some A-lister names for the main Deadpools.
I know the Welsh guy was Welshpool, who is Paul Mullins from Wrexham. If you ever seen the show Welcome to Wrexham, that's the soccer show.
Yeah.
With it's Ryan Reynolds' team. Like one of the main guy one of his best players, Paul Mullins, he let him go and dress up as Deadpool.
Oh, that's awesome,
so,
bro. That's crazy. So that was
cool his to see kids, that guy. His kids were in the movie too. So like
yeah,
the
his kid plays the freaking foul Deadpool, right?
And then the baby pool is
the
like
baby
his
one.
Son. Yeah, like his actual son. That's ridiculous. Like that's so awesome, dude.
That is just
beautiful.
The only cameo I said that I was pissed off that did not happen. Was because the same way, Welcome to Wrexham.
Taylor Swift, I knew it. No. I'm sorry.
Welcome to Wrexham. Okay. I mean, that should have been one too. Welcome to Wrexham is Ryan Reynolds and Rob McElhenney, who Rob McElhenney is from Always Sunny in Philadelphia. He plays Mac. So I knew he was going to be in the movie, I felt like. I was like, they have to, like they're best friends. Like they're owners of the same football club. Like they hang out together, they're really good friends. So apparently he had a cameo. He was a TVA soldier or agent.
Is that where he was?
And his scene got cut.
His entire scene got cut. Oh, wait a minute. Is that tweet I saw online that they were joking about it? He goes, I didn't see my thing. And he goes, and Ryan Reynolds said, yo, that was just a theater. Go to a different theater and watch it or something like that.
And he was like, if I go here,
I saw that tweet. I'm like, who's that guy?
Yeah, it was cut.
I had no idea.
It was cut.
Did they really cut it or was it just you don't see him because he's wearing his head?
I didn't think he just made it.
No, it was cut. They said he cut it.
Maybe it'll be.
But that's not Ryan Reynolds' fault, though.
Yeah, that's not Ryan Reynolds' fault, though.
It'll probably be like deleted scene
when
the movie comes out. Yeah.
For sure.
Right.
But yeah, I was upset about that.
That's terrible.
Yeah, it's like, but it's a joke between them. They're like, oh my God, like, of course they cut my scene, whatever. But
so
one person
funny,
they didn't cut and they put a lot in this movie is probably the real hero of this movie. His name is Peter. And Peter
was all over the movie.
Peter was everywhere, bro. Peter. Which, I mean, for good reason, because Peter was the star of Deadpool 2, along with Domino. We missed Domino.
I feel bad when you see Domino. It kind of felt weird that they didn't even mention her.
I'm going to mention something about that in a minute.
You are. Yeah. Good. Yeah, do it.
But Peter's the man. Basically, every Deadpool has a Peter. Basically, he's like Morty, like Rick and Morty. Like every Rick has a Morty. So every Deadpool has a Peter. So that was what Peter. As soon as Peter shows up, all the fighting stops.
Peter.
And everyone wants Peter. It's fine.
Every girl wants Peter, man.
Yeah, even what's her face from the TVA?
BB. Yeah, whatever. Yeah.
I love that. I was like, wow, okay, Peter.
The mustache. Oh.
Ooh. So we get to the final act, the final scene. Basically, they're trying to stop this, I think it's called a Time Ripper. It's a machine that they use to basically rip the timeline apart or like destroy the timeline. So this Time Ripper is trying to be controlled by Cassandra Nova. She's trying to control it so she can take over and do whatever. Deadpool and Wolverine.
By the way, that's dumb, but that made no sense.
It made no sense. Yeah.
Like Alex said, don't think of this.
That shit doesn't. Yeah, that shit made no sense.
That makes no sense. Like what are you trying
basically,
to do?
Basically, it was just a reason for Wolverine and Deadpool to come together, hold hands.
To come together.
Which, this scene, you had a lot of things happening.
Like Google Dolls.
Yeah, you had Wolverine, first of all. Not Wolverine, Hugh Jackman. His abs are out of control. Those are his actual abs. That's his actual frame, which is, I thought it was CG, to be honest. I'm like, there's no way this guy.
Dude, he worked out for a
bro,
year.
Bro, all the oil
ever.
And
said
the
way, it, yeah.
I'm like, bro, I look like shit compared to this guy. So I need to work on that.
If you get paid what he gets paid, I'm sure you get like that.
No, that's
too,
what I said to everybody. I'm like, yeah, you
Papi,
think he's hot,
you got your own trainer. You got
exactly,
your food,
exactly.
Everything.
That's what they pay you for, bro.
Way easier. Yep, way easier.
So they have this moment where Wolverine is trying, I think it's, no, it's Deadpool. Deadpool is trying to hold everything together, like to try to break the machine or whatever. And they have this moment. It reminded me of the first Guardians of the Galaxy, where they're holding hands. Yeah, and they have the music playing and they have the electricity going through
and
them.
They'll have to hold hands together.
Basically, that's all you got to do. Just hold hands to save the day. That's all that happens. So.
Yeah.
But Wolverine, Deadpool, they save the day there.
Sure explodes in slow motion. Well, yeah. Madonna starts singing.
Actually, before that, I forgot to mention, gorgeous, too.
Bro. Yeah.
One of the best scenes before they before they beat up all 100 Deadpools, they run into Handsome Pool, who's there. And Handsome Pool with Dog Pool. And Deadpool decides to say, hey, come with me. We're going to go run across. And Handsome Pool's getting shot. He's being used as a meat shield. While Deadpool is like, it's going to be okay. Just keep saying you're gonna make it. You're going to be alive. And they just make him explode. And while Deadpool's just trying to get across like the street. Then Wolverine has Dog Pool in his hand. And everybody stops shooting. They're like, wait, stop. Hold your fire. And Wolverine just walks across the street with Dog Pool in his face, like looking at everybody. He's like whatever, man. What the fuck is it? I love that scene so much.
It's the face he makes while walking. Like, what are we doing? What are we doing with our lives?
Like, all the Deadpools are just, they all stop. They shot freaking Handsome Pool to hell, bro. Like, bullet holes everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
And like Wolverine just walked across.
It
was a good scene. Then you got the Guardians of the Galaxy ending. And then you also have this ending where, hey, they say goodbye, but then Deadpool invites Wolverine over to live with, or to visit. I don't know if they're living together or not, with Blind Al.
They relived Avengers, the ending. Don't forget that.
Oh, the shawarma?
Shawarma, yeah, for Avengers.
It was invented by the Avengers, I think he said, or founded by the Avengers, I forgot.
He founded by the Avengers.
Yeah. Like, oh, yeah, they created this. It's fine. So they have the Avengers ending. The one thing I will say, I know we've praised this movie, and I will give it praise to the ends of the earth. On that. I mean, I'll let you add stuff on that.
But the ending, there's the final ending, the final shot. What does that final shot mean of the movie, though?
It's the mask?
Because you forgot to say that they brought... So they kind of alluded because when they were back in the... You kind of skipped over that. When they were fighting back in the...
On the basement?
What the hell? No, not in the basement. I'm sorry. Back in the, what's this place called?
TVA?
TVA. No, before
the,
that.
The Void?
When the Void, sorry. I was thinking of like the Rift. I don't know why. When they were in the Void, they were all fighting with all the characters, and they were all left behind, but they all kind of alluded that they were all about to die, right? When Deadpool and Wolverine escaped back to Earth. So they kind of left that in a cliffhanger. So then when we were back on TVA, I mean back on Earth with TVA, Deadpool asked for a request and said, hey, can you do something for my friends? They helped me to get here. Please save my friends. And the girl, because I guess she's in love with Peter now, whatever, you know, with the mustache, he's like, we'll see what we can do, blah, blah, blah. You know, left it very, left it all ambiguous. But then the last scene, which is kind of weird because we all thought this is Deadpool coming to the MCU, but it's not. We're going back, I guess, back to the Fox, which, again, I'm okay. I understand why they did that. It's Deadpool back in his apartment with his own family, but Laura joins him officially, which is cool because I like that you're bringing her into this world. I love that. We don't see the other characters, but I'm expecting they're alive because she's there. Then they gotta be somewhere.
Well, that goes back
and that's the ending.
Well, really, they're bringing that Wolverine into their universe because, like Alex alluded to, Logan was part of that Deadpool's universe, so Deadpool Prime's universe. So when he died,
right.
Well, Laura was still part of that universe. So Laura's back home now. Like, that's her home. She's part of that universe. Yeah. I mean, she didn't have a house because she lived in a fucking hospital back in Logan. She was a test tube baby.
Living in the woods, bro.
Yeah, living in the woods. So now she's with Deadpool, but they're in the same universe. Deadpool. So that's why I think she's there, but everybody else is not.
And everybody else probably back home somewhere else.
Yeah, their universe.
I'm assuming.
I'm
assuming. And Gambit was probably born.
Gambit went to X-Men 97 and he died at that big battle.
And he died again. Yeah. Spoilers.
Wow. So that's what happened.
Spoilers.
Poor Channing Tatum. But yeah, you got that ending, Deadpool and Wolverine's mask at the end and stuff like that. Very touching.
That was nice. I like that.
Very nice little ending. Again, the one thing that I will say, I know we've praised this, The one thing I will say that I did not like that I probably docked a point for is actually just the supporting characters that are part of Deadpool's life, as far as Vanessa, Colossus, Negasonic, Teenager, right. all that. They had little
they had
to
nothing
to do.
Blind Al.
And yeah, Blind Al. And that's the stuff that I actually enjoyed about the first two movies.
First two movies, a lot.
Like Dopinder and stuff like that. All the little quirks and jokes and stuff like that. Like that stuff. I like that. Even the thing with like Vanessa. I love the Vanessa storyline 1 and 2 because they were meant for each other.
So much Vanessa.
And she,
I mean, he was doing everything for her and their and his friends in this movie. That's the plot, I guess.
He did it for the friends, but then he never saw them, which I guess he was busy. But at the same time, like, Vanessa is like watered down. She's like just like every other girl. And she wasn't like that. She was like basically like Deadpool, but like a female version. She was Wade Wilson, but female with a vagina. Like she was very raunchy. She was like a sex worker when they met, like in the first Deadpool, you know, they met at the bar and went to skee ball and all that stuff.
Wolverine says, you're going to save your life. You're going to save a relationship with a stripper. He said that. And that's why he says, I'm going to fight you now.
I'm going to fight you now.
that was the line. Yeah, that was the line.
But isn't this supposed to be like this Vanessa? Isn't it in Deadpool 2? Forgive me if I'm wrong, but doesn't he like bring her back? Cause like technically she's dead. She dies.
She did so that, like, but she brought her back with a time
swap thing.
Machine
yeah. yeah. The end credit.
So I'm saying, like, wondering if, like, maybe that's a change of character arc because.
No, I mean, it's the same Vanessa.
I don't know. Just.
Nah, I get what you're going with, but at the same time, they didn't even mention it. Well, they mentioned Cable, but they said the audience didn't
Cable,
like it.
Yeah, they didn't like Cable.
That's messed up, by the way. That's messed up.
They should have mentioned something about Thanos. Like, they should have said, like, I mean, they did. And
they should have.
The second Deadpool, they actually mentioned.
They did.
Thanos on
they made
one,
the
yeah.
joke. I just think what you're saying is what's going on in Malik is that they wanted to focus strictly on Wolverine and Deadpool, and they had no time to do anything else. And it is.
I
what
mean,
it is.
When it's 2 hours and 8 minutes, that's what I'm going back to. It's just
should have been longer.
That mandate of the movies to be a certain length. I think it works in the case of a movie that maybe doesn't have as much substance. But this is the first time you're seeing Deadpool and Wolverine together after all these years that people have been anticipating it. So to flesh out some of the other characters, I think, like I said, I think another 15, 20 minutes wouldn't have hurt this movie to just give those extra moments that Mike was talking about.
Yeah. I mean, if you had an actual plot, like a lot of people have dissected this movie, a lot of critics, which, I mean, it is what it is. I get it. This movie is very paper thin. I understand. The movie, I'm not here to... I'm not here to seek Oscars when I watch this movie. I'm here to have fun.
Yeah, I mean, that's how both movies I feel like were. Both of them were like that. The Deadpool 1 and 2? Yeah, Deadpool 1 and 2 were
the
same way.
The first two.
I mean, Deadpool 1 was more of an origin story.
The first one, they feel it's deeper. The first one, people love it a lot because it's deeper.
Yeah,
when it comes to story.
That's an origin story that you get for the character. The second one was just him trying to save the...
It was fun. It was whatever.
He's trying to save the fat kid that was burning everything. And
fat kid.
And Cable showed up, you know, and that's it. Like that. I mean, there's not much of a story arc there.
There's
either.
Not much of a story. The first one was the deeper. You can tell it was a movie more about heart. This one, again, I feel this one had heart. It did because there was some emotional beats here and there. But you definitely need to write a lot more, like Alex said, to flesh out all those characters. And it would have taken more time to do the movie. It is what it is. Maybe remember we had the writer strike, we had the actor strike.
Not true.
Yeah. All that delayed this movie a long time. So we don't know.
Yeah.
You know, it is what it is.
And I think, like, to be honest, I don't think it would have had as much heart if it wasn't for Hugh Jackman in it. I think he brought a lot to the role.
Oh, he brought his A-game.
He definitely brought it up. So for him, I think that was what kind of grounded the movie and gave it, like, the heart that it needed. Outside of like the Deadpool was, you know, it's funny and it's fun, you know what I'm saying? But again, if it wasn't for like the Wolverine part of it, I think maybe it would have probably focused more on like the Vanessa, that whole storyline. Colossus didn't say one goddamn thing this whole movie. Like Colossus wasn't even there, which I was pissed off about.
I love Colossus, man.
Yeah.
He's so funny.
And then Kimiko, the girlfriend of like they have one moment in the beginning and that was it, you know? And that's funny too. Like the way Deadpool interacts with that. Like
the way
interacts
with
it's always great. Yeah, yeah. So that stuff that I miss.
That's so great.
You know, so that's the only thing that
I do,
said
I do.
That I like between that and the opening credit where it replaces, you know, all the names.
With the slow motion. Like,
those
names,
two are the only things that I could say that
But you got bye-bye, so shut up.
Yeah, exactly. So I can't be mad about it.
You got NSYNC. You the got song, to the point that NSYNC had to rename the song, bro, on YouTube.
Yeah.
I saw that too. It's like that on Apple Music too and everything else.
That's insanity.
Yeah. Yeah, like if you go look it up, it says the song from Deadpool.
That's
like,
dude, and all the comments, it's all about Deadpool now. Like on the top comments, like after 15 years. Are you serious? That's crazy.
I'm sure they're loving it, dude. It's freaking resurgent for them.
They're getting
paid
for that. It's not free.
Yeah, Justin Timberlake needs it. He needs all the bail money he can get.
Justin Timberlake. I know that stupid solo tour that he did.
Yeah.
It's terrible. Listen, how would you feel if I have to ask you? Okay, I have one thing. One of my gripes in that whole cave cameos or supporting characters, whatever you want to call
it. Scarlet Witch House, yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
If you can replace one of those actors and bring another one, you know, to make it, let's just say, a little bit more impactful, can you name one actor you can replace right now on top of your head and with another one you would have brought in for a bigger impact? Because I got two names on top of my head that would have been so much better.
I'd be curious to hear your answers. I don't really... Sure. For me personally, I don't see anybody else in that position.
In that group? Okay.
Like, not that I wouldn't want it. Like, you know, for fantasy casting, of course. But from a story perspective, I can't think of one that would make sense.
I'm talking about story. And story perspective, I got two names that I think would have elevated that scene like way higher.
Well, tell me.
Story wise, I would have had two.
Okay, you go.
I would have had Jean Grey. Be one.
So you would add Jean Grey in the cave. Okay, I like that.
And then just for like maybe fan service and maybe part of the storyline would have been Magneto, but it would have been
the young Magneto
with long. Like long white hair, like 97,
like the cartoon
like
look,
97.
The sexy cartoon look. Oh.
Like whatever his name is, I forgot that guy's name from fucking. What's his name? The actor's name, wasn't it Michael something?
Fassbender.
Yeah. Have him with the long silky Magneto hair, like sexy Magneto, and have
but
him come
already,
out. Bro,
great. That wouldn't work because they already said that they killed Magneto in that universe.
No, but I'm saying that they can't say that would have to be replaced. They can't say those lines. Yeah, no, I know what you're saying.
No, but they did say it because remember they're like, yeah, they killed him and they smashed his helmet when they were talking about putting his helmet.
No, they said in that scene, but that's what Michael was saying, that they would not say that. They would have been way different.
Yeah. I think you see. Okay. They said they had a lot of Magneto. They had a lot of variants came in. Like Cassandra Nova said that. She's like, yeah, we've had a lot of variants. I've had a lot of Sabretooths come in, but you're the first Wolverine that's first been here Wolverine. That I want.
Actually, which I think is funny.
Yeah.
But okay.
Exactly. So that's what I'm saying. That works. Well, because they don't die. They don't get.
They don't die. Multiple.
Like, they don't need it.
All
right, who do you get?
The names I have in my head that I was kind of pissed because one of them was reference. One of them would have been Thomas Jane. He should have been in
the
that
Punisher.
Group. Yes, the pun. They even mentioned the Punisher.
But
that
why
was
would
the
that
bazooka.
Be impactful though?
Because that was the Punisher from that same era, huh?
Yeah, but to who? Like that wouldn't further any storyline. That just would have been like, oh, Thomas Jane.
No.
But that he
was
had
Blade
no.
There?
Exactly. Why was he there?
Oh, I'm sorry. Very regarded. Retarded?
Well, no. That actually would have made sense because Ryan Reynolds was in Blade Trinity. And I felt like they could have made so much reference on that.
They did make the jokes to that. Oh, I never liked you. Well, yeah, you never liked me. Well, whatever. Yeah, they made those jokes. Oh, okay. Yeah, I know. I get it. Right. But they made the reference to the Punisher. I was like, oh man, because I was thinking
Punisher,
of Thomas Jane, because that would have been lit. Because Thomas Jane always wanted to come back for something Punisher, but he never had the chance because of
the
studio.
No, let's have the new Punisher should have had him in there.
No, because then they probably would have killed him off.
You can't though, because he's gonna be part of this whole
Daredevil. That would have got really confusing, by the way. I was thinking from old school. Fine, if you don't want to bring Punisher, you know which one would have everybody screaming? Ghost Rider.
Nick Cage.
Yes.
No.
That would have brought down the
house. That would have brought your house down, bro. You would have had a wet dream. That's it.
Your mom's house. Yeah. Everyone's house.
That would
have
brought
down.
Have
you seen the Ghost Rider movies?
That would have brought down my score of this movie by a point because all I would have thought about was Nick Cage from The Flash. and I would have been like literally off air, bro.
You're talking about DC stuff.
It doesn't matter. I don't want to see him right now in any of these superhero movies.
You just saw Daddy Long Legs and you love that movie.
I said superhero movie though, not
like
I'll watch the original.
No, no, let him cook. Listen. But no, Ghost Rider. I mean, it's gonna be hard to cast him, bro. He's still a good Ghost Rider.
You already have enough.
He would have fit in that
old
group.
People in that group, though. I'm saying, like, who would you have replaced them with, though? That's the real question.
Get Elektra out of there. She didn't belong in that group at all. She was boring. She did nothing.
No, Elektra's always been.
Look at that, Elektra got quiet.
Elektra has always been useless, to be honest. Like, she has freaking Raphael nunchuck, the freaking size, and that's it.
The size.
That's all she got. I'm like, okay, she knows karate. That's it.
I think she got casted because I think originally Ben Affleck was going to be in the movie and then he stepped out. I think that's what I
heard. As he should.
I heard a while ago.
As he should.
But it could be true or not. Who knows?
As he should, because he didn't want to be next to her, bro.
It's weird having Elektra.
Once again, I don't want any DC references right now. Like, just keep
back. No,
well, you got one. You got Cavill. DC's Wolverine, bro.
Oh, you're talking about Ben Affleck.
Other than that, I'll take him. I'll take him because of how they treated him.
Him and his mustache, yeah.
But, hold on. What I was going to say was that I'm still optimistic because I know, listen, guys, you know it's true. They're going to have to go mega huge, like bigger than for the Secret Wars. And
dude,
a lot of those people.
That's just what I talked to with Michael, like not to get on too much of a different tirade or whatever.
Yeah.
But we're gonna get there actually because I have that.
When we were driving and leaving the theater, that was what my conversation was. How do you go up from here? And the only way I was like, you have to bring back people that are instantaneously going to be big names. And that's exactly what they did with Robert Downey.
Oh, come on. Let's spoil it. We're going to get there.
Come on.
We didn't even give our freaking. That's what I'm trying to do. You're skipping around 500 times.
Oh,
bro.
My God. Suck my.
Oh. No, right, but yes, they have to bring everybody back. Everybody's
whatever. Here we go.
Just cut that part out, and then we'll pretend I'll say it again.
I'm gonna cut you out
later.
Sure.
Yeah.
Here we go. So we have our scores, our final scores here. How many claws do you give Deadpool and Wolverine? We'll start with Omar first. Since you've seen it twice, how many claws?
I'm gonna give it a negative.
Wow.
9.5.
Negative 9.5.
9.5.
Jesus. A regular 9.5? Not negative? Positive?
Yeah, just messing. Yes.
Positive 9.5. All right.
Yes.
Alex,
nine and a half claws. Nine and a half claws. I don't know how you get half a claw.
It's a whiskey
claw.
He had a whiskey claw.
Well, I'm not going to give it a 10. It's not perfect. I have gripes from the movie.
Ew. All right. Alex?
Michael's going to do it.
I'm going to be completely transparent with you guys, and I'm sorry, but as someone that has gone through some of the worst Fox properties, Fox movies, and I still enjoy them to this day. And as I sat down before I watched this movie,
right.
I did a whole rewatch of every single X-Men movie, even the Origins ones, even the shitty ass. What was the last one? The freaking New Mutants and the.
I skipped that one.
Yeah, you're alone that one.
I watched that one, and
why?
I'm not saying it was good. I'm just saying the ebbs and flows of that universe is similar to this movie, but not as deep in terms of like going to a deep, you know, flow. Like if there's any tightening or things like we talked about, you know, things that I felt like could have happened to make this movie even better. But that's just me nitpicking as a fan and saying I want there to be more explanation of things, you know what I'm saying? But am I going to be upset about it? No, because I think honestly, this is the best Deadpool movie we've gotten out of all three of them for sure. And I would say honestly that Wolverine is what set it off, you know, like just seeing Hugh Jackman as a character. I never thought I would see that again, to be honest with you, because I remember when he walked away, he was like, I don't want to do this ever, you know, anymore. So I thought for a while we were going to miss out on that opportunity.
No,
so,
bro. It's like Vince McMahon, bro. Never say never.
I guess, you know, it's true. When you roll out the money bags and give people money. But like, honestly,
until you're 90,
this movie was everything. You know, like there was funny Deadpool goofy moments, raunchiness in terms of crazy language, you know, things that I never thought I would hear in a freaking Disney movie.
A Will Smith joke, by the way. Michael, you got it.
I didn't get it.
You got the Will Smith joke.
I didn't
hear many freaking jokes. Like,
you didn't get it?
No, I didn't hear it. I need to watch it with
keep my country out of your mouth. Yeah, he did. Come on, man.
That's right. Yeah,
I remember. How can you not get it?
I remember.
Yeah, I know you got that.
And that's one of the things about Deadpool is just like the comedy element is always so relevant to what we're seeing in the world. And it's always been the like that wall, in the comics. The fourth wall, exactly. Just such great comedy. Ryan Reynolds. Honestly, I would say I don't ever want to see another Deadpool other than him. I don't ever want to see another Wolverine.
It's going to be tough to recast.
It's going to be hard.
That,
yeah.
Super.
Like for me, Wolverine, I think they could still recast, but I don't think there will ever be another Hugh Jackman. Like the way he took that role and just skyrocketed with it. This movie was great to see the tiebacks to Logan, but also stand alone, which I think Logan still was like one of the best movies in terms of a Wolverine origin that you've ever seen or anything related to his character. But this was great to see another iteration of Wolverine extended, you know? So I got to give this 10 out of 10 claws, bro. I'm sorry, but
I forgot. I was like waiting for the number. I'm like, all right, what's the
10 out of 10, bro? The action, the fighting, the bloodiness, the goriness, I wanted more of it. You know, I left that movie like I could sit here.
Yeah, you
here
wanted
and
more. I want more too.
I would be happy if they were to come out with another Deadpool Wolverine movie in the next couple of years. I would not bat an eye and be upset about it. I'd be okay with it.
I wish.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to keep mine simple. I'm giving this 9 out of 10. The only reasons, again, like I said, it was more of the characters that weren't the OG Deadpool cast. That weren't really incorporated in it as much. And same thing with like the opening credits didn't bother me that much because I loved NSYNC, so it was fine.
Yeah.
But it was more just like the Vanessa and Colossus and not having like Dopinder there and stuff like that. The Blind Owl stuff, you know, you had like one moment and that was it. That was the same one they had in the trailer, so it didn't, you know, wasn't like anything crazy. But, you know, I wish they kind of like revisited a little bit more of like the OG Deadpool and give that some respect, you know, respect them forever.
I will say this movie gave Fox their respect, though. I will say that much. Like the Fox
properties. Well, it was a love letter to Fox. Yeah.
And even the post credit that we talked about, like I got emotional watching that and seeing like, you know, freaking
it's Green
Patrick
Day, bro.
Stewart
it's
as like Day. The young Patrick Stewart. And then even Wolverine when he's, or Hugh Jackman when he's first trying on the suit, like
first
I was
day.
Like, this is so fucking cool, like to see stuff like that, you know. So that's it.
So before we go on and close this chapter, guys, what was your favorite fight scene in this movie?
Well, favorite one?
You haven't thought about that yet?
No, I mean, I had honestly, it's hard to choose between the opening and
one,
the Wolverine and the Honda Odyssey fight. I think was great. I think that might have been maybe my favorite. The Honda
Which
Odyssey fight.
Favorite?
The Honda Odyssey fight. I think that was
okay. Okay. Yeah. And you, Alex?
It's a toss up between the Honda Odyssey one and the 100 Deadpool. But I think the 100 Deadpool one might have been my favorite only because it was just so ridiculous. And the way it was shot was like
the
really
2D
cool. Like
beat
that
up.
Little side view. It just felt like I was reading like a comic and like kind of following it.
It was like, it was straight out of panel.
Yeah. So
and the way it ends with this guy falling on the floor.
Exactly.
Of course, you got to ruin the whole thing.
Yeah.
And my favorite, by the way, it's probably the minivan.
In your car.
Stupid. Because you never see it into my car. Yeah. Because you never see a minivan get massacred like that.
No, that was crazy, dude. Like at the end of it where you saw
so
it,
gross.
Just saw all the blood everywhere.
No. And then it just the way it ends. And then when we fade back to them, they're just like tied up.
They're just like,
sleeping next to each other.
Cheater. Cheater.
It's just reminding me of that. Cheater.
Cheater.
They're so dead. Like how would that fight ever end? Like you just fight forever, bro. Like AW all day long. That band.
All right. Well,
it was so good.
I know we ended the Deadpool review, but let's end it on this note here because Alex kind of alluded to it, and I wanted to allude to it not only did we have Deadpool and Wolverine release that weekend, last weekend, but we also had, or the weekend before, whenever it was, but we also had our announcement from San Diego Comic-Con that we had the Russo brothers, who had directed a lot of movies, including Winter Soldiers, Captain America's Winter Soldier, Ant-Man. Civil War, Ant-Man. Ant-Man? Did they do Ant-Man? Well, they didn't. Shut up. shut up.
Quantumania.
Quantumania.
Peyton Reed.
Then we had, yeah, they also directed, you know, the Avengers Infinity War and Endgame, which are the two GOAT movies. They're coming back to direct the last two Avengers movies, which one is, of course, Secret Wars that we had. The other one that was originally titled The Kang Dynasty is now renamed to Doomsday, Avengers Doomsday. They did a reveal at San Diego Comic-Con that revealed Robert Downey Jr. as Dr. Doom, which has, I feel, some mixed reviews online. We have a lot of people that are excited. Yeah,
people
but then
are confused.
You have,
I think people are just confused online, dude.
So I was confused as well. And then
more confused.
And then I ran into this YouTube, you know, suggested for you because I was watching some stuff on, you know, Deadpool Wolverine, and one came up that that was Iron Man as Dr. Doom explained. It was actually uploaded by a site called Comics.
Why is everybody so confused? Like, I don't understand what's so confusing about it.
From what I've seen, a lot of people they personally think that this guy straight up. Robin Downey Jr., he's just playing Bond Doom, like this older, brand new character, and they're not going to acknowledge that, wait a minute, I know you as Iron Man. Like, you look familiar. They're not going to...
Is that why you're confused?
It's not that.
Is that why you're confused, Michael?
I didn't say I was confused.
No, you were confused,
and then you watched a YouTuber that explained something.
Yeah, because I was trying to figure out how that was going to... How the comics... Story. You know, like explained right. it. And then the literal YouTube channel is called Comic Explain. And they explain there's a comic. Yeah. I forgot the name of it, but I don't know how recent it is.
Immortal or?
It's
the infamous Iron Man, there it is. Yep.
I don't know if that's the one that it is, but it's basically,
no, that's it.
It's basically one that is similar to, if you watch the show What If, it basically has the Watcher in it.
Breaking Bad, Iron Man. Yep.
So it's the Watcher on that, but no, this one I don't know if it's the same one, but this one actually has to do with Dr. Doom, but it's a What If scenario. You know the show What If, right? With the Watcher
what
and
if,
all
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
So how they have the different scenarios. What if T'Challa was Star Lord? What if this person was this way?
Right.
So there's a comic that has What If Dr. Doom, Von Doom, actually roomed with Tony Stark instead of Reed. Reed Richards. So, you know, in every story of the Fantastic Four, they've been in college, you know, Reed Richards and Dr. Doom, they college roommates and stuff like that. They went to school together and they knew each other. So What If comic, that's an official comic, basically had it to where Tony Stark was instead like the Richard Reed of it. And they basically, you know, butted heads because Tony Stark and Von Doom are like different people. But eventually it comes to like this respect, like a grudgingly they respect each other, and Dr. Doom respects Tony Stark, and then he asks him for like help to help him with a project that he's working on. And they go downstairs to this basement, and he basically has Tony Stark hooked up to this machine and is like, oh yeah, we're going to test it out. But then he locks Tony Stark in there and he's like, well, to be honest, like I kind of lied to you about what's happening. This has to do with like telekinetic stuff, but what I'm going to do basically in a nutshell is transfer your brain and your thoughts into me. So we're basically going to do like a Freaky Friday situation where you're Tony Stark, your body is Tony Stark, but Dr. Doom is inside it. 'Cause I want the same privileges that you got as Tony Stark. I want to be the one with all the power and everything like that. So in this comic, that's what happens. Dr. Doom is now Tony Stark in the mind. Like the mind of Tony Stark is in Dr. Doom's body. And then he goes on to whatever he's from, Vatlania, wherever that freaking country is that Dr. Doom's from. His country, yeah.
Back to home planet.
So Tony Stark, which is Dr. Doom, gets his degree over there and does like an arc reactor thing. Basically does Tony Stark shit, except he's Dr. Doom. Then on the other side, and he has no memory of what happened. He has no idea, like, why his brain, he doesn't remember anything previous to that day. And then Dr. Doom in Tony Stark's body is now part of, like, you know, doing Stark Enterprises and is actually killing people. Like, he kills Tony Stark's father, like an assassination Howard, thing. Yeah. And then he eventually builds, like, his own Iron Man suit. But the Iron Man suit is actually green. Like, it's a green Iron Man suit.
Yeah.
Which looks like dope. Then Tony Stark, that's in Dr. Doom's body, builds a rescue suit. So it's not a battle suit, but it's a rescue suit that is
like
Dr. Doom, but except it's the colors of Iron Man. So it's like the red and gold. And then Dr. Doom with the green Iron Man suit comes and fights Tony Stark or Dr. Doom, however you want to say it. They basically fight each other. It gets confusing. And then at the end of it, Dr. Doom, which is Tony Stark, ends up beating, you know, the bad guy, Tony Stark. And then that's the end of the comic. Like, there's no ending to it. So what they were saying is, what if that happened? But instead, Tony Stark, who is aka Dr. Doom, just kills Doom completely and then takes over Stark Industries. And now he's Tony Stark, but a Dr. Doom version of it. Like, that's what I got from this video and from that comic. So I don't know if it's the same one. I think you guys are talking
about
a different one.
It's going to be a Tony variant. It's obviously a Tony variant, but I get evil Tony variant, which obviously we know it means it's going to be Doom. Yeah.
Is that going to be...
The thing is, there's different... So the arc you're talking about is completely different from what I'm
thinking. From what you guys are thinking about, yeah, because I think you guys are talking about something
else. The infamous Iron Man, there's a whole different one. That's like a newer comic that had come out within the last, I'd say, 6-7 years. So it's still kind of fresh and new to where a lot of people don't know that one as much as probably the one you're talking about. But this one's still essentially kind of the same thing, where he just in a world where instead of him being Iron Man or that Tony Stark, he ends up becoming the Dr. Doom character or persona, basically. So I don't know. I don't know how they're going to go with it, but.
But either way, you're both on the right track. It's not gonna be like Robin Downey Jr., the actor, playing a new character with a new name, and they're gonna play it off like it's a new character. Like, you know what I'm trying to say? And
well, not, yeah, like it's not.
They're
the
not gonna
same.
Treat like a new character. Yeah, yeah. They're gonna be like, why does this guy look like
Tony Stark?
I'll tell you what right now. Take this to the bank, guys. I'm not going to say this is happening, but it's going to be like this. Why? You know how they've done such a really crappy job with this buildup, and we talked about this already, the MCU, Phase 4, Phase 5, we know that. The opening of Infinity War, do you remember how it opened?
Infinity War that opened on the ship that Thor was on?
Yep. Who died? Who died in the opening?
Loki.
That's it. That opening, enough. That was like, whoa. Scary, right? And the way Thanos knocked out Hulk, scary, right? And then boom, Avengers, right? Imagine us being, because I know they're going to probably do a cameo with him in Fantastic Four, but we're not going to get much of that, obviously. But when they do Avengers Doomsday, imagine the opening, bro. This guy, like the new Tony Stark, showing up to Pepper Potts in the opening. And this girl's like, what do you look like, Tony? Or whatever, right? And this guy killing her off as she's trying to get into the rescue suit and whatever. Obviously running off, trying to, you know, try to, with Morgan. I think it was Morgan, the kid, right? Was it Morgan? Yeah, it was Morgan. I love you 3000, yeah, whatever it was. Yeah. Imagine this guy, evil guy, whatever. Like, but you know, that's not Tony Stark. Not kills Morgan, but kills Pepper Potts or kills Happy. Something screwed up, bro. Boom, bah. Avengers Doomsday, like, and dude, that's how you know this is for real. Like, we're not playing games anymore, and I think they're gonna have to do an opening like that, because how do you create a story or get people to watch this movie where they haven't really showed us why he's scary, why they need the Avengers, why, you know, why do we fear this guy? And having this guy having that face of a guy that we recognize, and they're gonna be like, why do you look like a guy we recognize? That's gonna be pretty screwed up. But I think they could do it well.
A lot of people were complaining because they're saying how Dr. Doom in a lot of scenarios never takes his mask off. So there, I think that's what a lot of fans are mad about.
Get the crap off.
To get around that. But at the same time, I understand why they would do it for the emotional element of the movie. You know, like
exactly.
If it makes sense for a story purpose, it's not.
He'll take it off when he wants to take it off for the emotional part. Imagine him taking it off in front of Pepper, bro. Right there, how she falls on the floor and she goes, "What?"
Well, you know what? Somebody was saying a fan theory was, "What if they had he's in the middle of a battle, like fighting, you know, like the Avengers, and like Spider-Man is there, like Tom Holland Spider-Man, and he knocks his mask off, and then he looks at him and he's like." He's like, Mr. Stark, you know, like all these years later, like, then you're like, oh shit, like that would be fucking crazy. So
I don't know how they would do that because I don't know how they're going to do it.
No. But he also forgot like all these things that happened up until that point. Remember? Because that's how No Way Home ends.
The world forgot about Spider-Man.
Well, the whole world forgot about Peter Parker. Peter Parker didn't forget about Iron Man.
I think they forgot about him too, bro. Even Sony forgot about him.
Hopefully they forgot
about it. We got no plans of Spider-Man 4.
Don't say that,
sucks.
Bro. Don't say
I know.
That.
Listen, I'm sad too. I won the announcement, bro. I'm still winning, man. It sucks.
I referenced was it's called What If Iron Man Demon in an Armor, Volume 11. So that's the name of the issue. Demon in an Armor. Okay. It's basically what if Tony Stark was in that. So
what if Tony Stark breaking bad? So whatever.
What I was thinking is that easily. Mm-hmm. They can integrate this into an end credit scene on Fantastic Four.
Fantastic Four,
the timeline that it starts in and how old they are, like 60s, 70s and stuff like that. That's probably around the time that Dr. Doom was going to college. And same thing with like Tony Stark at that timeline. So if you have an end scene where it's Tony Stark and Dr. Doom, like whoever, they could pick a Dr. Doom character. I don't know who they would pick. But if they have them together and then they do that what if thing and switch the minds and stuff like that, that's honestly like the easiest way to do it. Because that's at the beginning of, that's like at the start of Tony Stark Industries and Doom Industries. And then I would honestly love for them to do that. Because not only does it take that story and integrate it with the Fantastic Four, but also the what if. Like what if has been one of the best shows I think that Marvel has put out there as far as like animation, anything like that. And I think to bring that into like the MCU universe to be like, all right, it's a variant of Tony Stark, right? But this was also in the past. Like this is a past Tony Stark. He's a younger Tony Stark. He could have been like the MIT, you know, how they had that stupid thing in, was it Endgame? What? Well, you know, they had that the virtual reality set. No, it was Civil War.
Oh,
so like War, they show this flashback of him in college same thing. They could do it with him, but it's the real thing that happened, like a real memory that happened, and they could just swap that.
I think the theory you're saying is a little bit more on point because the one, so Infamous.
I think they're talking about the infamous Iron Man thing too.
It's more based on the idea that after Civil War II, which hasn't technically happened in this story arc that we're in,
and like MCU,
like what ends up happening is Von Doom, who's the actual Doom himself, takes over the mantle as Tony Stark. So that's a different altogether type of thing. It's like actually Von Doom taking his place, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
So it's not like what you're saying is there's a version of him where there's some mind swapping or something happens to where it's still Tony in his body, but because now
Tony's mind is in the body of Dr. Doom, and Dr. Doom is in Latvia. So honestly, in the movie, in the Doomsday, Dr. Doom, whoever is playing Dr. Doom, could essentially be the hero of the story, taking out Tony Stark. Because the body's Tony Stark, but the mind is not.
I actually think that would make more sense, because another thing I was thinking is that even though Robert Downey's coming back for this, I don't think longevity wise, he's going to be the Von Doom character the entire length. Like,
oh, no, I give him max 2-3 movies. That's it.
This would be them setting up Doom, but then you could always have whoever the actor is that you want
as Doom
be the one that continues.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They could easily bring, they could easily do the flashback. It could be Robert Downey Jr. in college, and then what's his name? Cillian Murphy. And have him be Doom. And then he could actually be the one that actually saves the day at the end. Because everybody wants Cillian Murphy. Like, everybody wants, I expected that. A lot of
the original fan cast.
So if you still have him as Doom, essentially he's still Doom, but he would be the hero in this story. He would be the one to take down Tony Stark. And then let's just say that something happens, like he gets back to his original self, and then he could be Doom going forward. You know, like the real sinister Doom. So I think that's honestly the best way to do it. Like if I was in charge of this, that's how you do it. That's how you do it.
Well, and that's how you can also loophole in another version of Tony that what I've been saying that I want to see happen eventually would be Spider-Man has the AI of Tony Stark that helps guide him in this new era, because if you read the new comics of Spider-Man, he eventually takes over the Avengers.
Oh, Spider-Man!
The AI is Tony Stark that's guiding him, not the one that he has in the suit, the one in like Homecoming and all the other ones. But they kind of like alluded to that in Far From Home, like when he has like the glasses from him and he's like hearing the message from him. Like that could be a way they integrate that somehow.
Yeah, I forgot what the name of the AI was. It's like, even in death, I win or something like that. Edith.
Even in death, I'm still the hero.
Still the hero.
Edith, I'm still the hero, yeah.
Even in death, I'm the hero, yeah.
Yeah.
So that's honestly probably the best
douche
scenario. But yeah, check out those links. I'll actually put them in the episode description too. I sent it in the chat here. There's a... What If Demon in Armor and that YouTube video that I just sent in the chat. Like, check that out.
I think I have some of the infamous Iron Man ones too. I got a couple of those. So
yeah, I think he explains that video. He also explains, like, he has a different video that's infamous Iron Man. But this one that I put in the chat, it's from that Demon in the Armor where he becomes Dr. Doom, which I feel would be a better way of incorporating this.
But I will say, for everyone that's upset about it, I don't know why you're upset, because Robert Downey's about to put on a fucking clinic right now.
Let them cook.
Acting-wise.
Dude, you're going to get Chris Evans again. You're going to get all of them back.
And you're going to have the Russos back. Like, come on, man. They've made some of the best action movies in terms of like superhero ones. But then even when they left, the stuff they were doing. Because didn't they do the one with Chris Hemsworth? The one that we like on Netflix?
No, that's, they produced that.
Yeah,
they produced it. Okay.
The ones that they did, like directing, this is like the Gray Man. They haven't done much stuff, honestly.
They did one with Chris Evans, I think. That was like
the Gray Man.
The problem, the Russo brothers are amazing, but people say that they work tremendously under Kevin Feige. They're missing that ingredient, and it was Kevin Feige. Without Kevin Feige, it's like they feel like they're directionless. And that happens all the time. That's normal, man.
It's like Zack Snyder, bro. It's like Zack Snyder.
Well, there you go. Maybe Snyder needs to work with Kevin Feige.
No, he just needs to be a producer and like actually make shots and curate that, but not direct.
Yeah, compose them. Like,
yeah, he doesn't have a director.
Well, he can't write stories.
Yeah. I mean, I do I'll end with this. I do understand why people are upset, because there's a double standard as far as like Jonathan Majors and his legal troubles versus Robert Downey Jr. and the legal troubles he had back then, even though it was the past. Yes, we
it was like 50 years ago.
I mean, it was 20-30 years ago, whatever it was, 30 years ago.
And he also by the way, he also went to jail, you know that, right?
Yeah, he went to jail and all that stuff. Yeah. So
like, but those same people that are upset weren't upset all the years that he played Iron Man. Now all of a sudden they want to be upset about it. I understand the double standard element, and I do agree in terms of what happened with him was obviously very fast the way Disney reacted. But I understand why, because they're always trying to not Look what they did with James Gunn. They did the same shit where they got rid of him.
Oh, dude. That man got canceled before you could say James.
And then now they brought him back and he did Guardian. So who's to say that this he couldn't come? He could come back at some point, maybe later down the line. But right now, like, I understand why they did what they had to do.
Story-wise, it's not.
And honestly, they don't need him right now. He did it to himself. He should have never put himself in that fucking position, bro. Like, I'm sorry, but... Like, you're at the height of your career, and he was doing some amazing things that you got to just keep yourself, you know, above water or not. So am I defending one side or another? No, I'm not. I think everybody's at fault in this situation, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So he didn't make it easier on him. And at the end of the day, I like DC is a shittier side of things. Because, look, they just let Ezra Miller run free and...
I can't believe you remember that. I forgot about Ezra Miller, dude.
I saw he said Miller in the chat. I'm like, Miller who? Miller Light?
Yeah,
Miller?
I was like, who? Like Miller Time?
That's why I'll take.
No, seriously, Henry I forgot Cavill. About that, that dude. Like, I mean, he's done. Like, oh, whatever. That person's done, dude.
He's done now, but look at what. But I'm saying they still released the movie and let it come out like as if.
Oh, the Flash! Flash! Yeah, thing was, of course.
But I mean, if you want to equate it, they released.
But was it too late? But was it too late for freaking Catwoman? Or what was the...
Oh, Batgirl. I would have taken Batgirl 20 times before Flash. That's for sure. There's no way that's worse. There's no way.
Release the cut.
Release the alpha cut.
Yeah. The first cut. Any cut.
I'll take
it. Release the rough draft. I don't care, bro.
I'll take it. I don't care. Don't even edit it. I'll take it.
Just raw footage, bro.
I'll edit it.
I'll edit it myself. We'll make our own Batgirl movie.
I'll do the Thanos ending. I'll do it myself.
I'll edit this myself.
I'll do it myself. There's no way that's worse than Flash. No freaking way, bro. Dude, the directors of that movie was the guys who did what the heck was it? Was it Bad Boys? Yeah.
No way.
Batgirl.
And Ms. Marvel.
Oh, Batgirl, you're talking about. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought you meant the Flash. Batgirl.
There's no way. I mean, I know the budget wasn't as crazy as Bad Boys or whatever, right? But they have style when it comes to the cinematography. It's not. Flash was super. Well, you saw Flash. You know what it was?
Flash is trash.
Yeah, it was
CGI.
It was babies in a freaking microwave. Come on,
oh
man.
Oh my god, I forgot. I totally forgot about that whole movie, bro. You just mentioned it. I'm like, oh god, trauma, dude. Bro.
And they had CGI Henry Cavill, bro. They ruined it, bro. Like, wait, what?
Henry Cavill?
Yeah, at the end, like when they
he's in that movie.
The whole scene when they're in
the background.
When he's running, like, and then he's running through time, and they have Nick Cage. Yeah,
yeah. When they had, like, all the CG, they couldn't bother to freaking bring him to on set. You know what's sad? Like, Cage was actually on set. You know that, right?
I heard, yeah, that he actually filmed it one day
with him.
Yeah, he was like, I think I read the interview. He said, oh, yeah, I just did my eyes, like, to make them look sad, and that was it.
Yeah.
But I did nothing else. Yeah.
Why were you there? They're not going to use you.
DC is AIing, yep.
That was fun.
Corners, bro.
It was.
Okay.
Stupid, bro.
I think filming is cheaper, but you do you.
Yeah, yeah. Just film it. Put them in the costume. That's it.
Just put the costume and film it. Always, right?
All I'll say is...
No, AI, bro. AI.
I think Marvel is slowly on the way up, hopefully. As long as... The only thing... The only concern I have...
Captain America 4.
Well, that's what we were talking about. The only concern I have is how they're going to close off this...
Thunderbolts.
This actual we phase. Have
the actually, you know what? I'm excited for that one. Believe it or not, I'm a little excited.
Nah,
Thunderbolts 4. I like the casting. I like what I keep hearing behind the scenes.
It's the same cast as Falcon and Winter Soldier, bro. So you should love Captain America 4.
No, they have a lot more in that movie.
I don't know.
Thunderbolts? No, they have more. I think I don't know. There's something about Captain. I told you, Captain America 4, there's just something weird about that movie. That movie just reminds me a lot of a Disney show.
This phase is just a wash, bro, at this point. There's been, you know, good movies. Like, obviously, we had Guardians and this one, Deadpool.
Yeah, they had their...
I think Cap 4 and Thunderbolts are going to be trash, and then they're going to come out with Fantastic 4.
Don't say that.
I think Fantastic 4 is going to be the start. That's it, bro.
Mike,
that's what I'm saying. That's why it says first steps. That's what it's called.
First step. No, but listen, dude. If Kevin Feige came back and he reshot 80% of Captain America 4, And Thunderbolts, he redid the whole script before he started shooting, and it's still trash. Then Kevin Feige, we need to sit down.
No, I think it's going to be Marvel Jesus. Come here. I think it's still going to be a decent movie, but
it has to be better than whatever it was before 2 years ago.
I just don't know how it's going to tie into whatever we're seeing.
That's the thing. That's a tie-in, I don't know how they got up to. Yeah, how is that going to tie up to Secret Wars, like, or Doomsday?
Or Doomsday,
that's weird, right?
The only thing we were saying is, like, is there going to be some type of like them explaining who these new Avengers are, because we don't even know who the hell the Avengers are.
No,
like leading into Doomsday. We don't know who any of the Avengers are, other than Cap now, probably.
We don't have a team. Right now, there's no team right now.
Yeah.
No, they're making a team with the
Hawkeye and
Ms. Marvel.
No, wait. No, what? Hawkeye.
Okay. Yeah, the girl Hawkeye. Yeah, girl
Hawkeye. Lady Hawkeye. What's her face? Kate Bishop. I heard that she's supposed to be recruiting.
And Ms. Marvel,
right?
That was the ending of Ms. Marvel.
I see it, but I heard about that.
Well, the Marvels. It. Yeah.
That's it. That's her team.
Listen, now if I see... Like, if Captain 4 ends and they bring out, like, Tom Holland and he walks out and then they're, like they're all there. Yeah. Like, then I'm like, all right, Kevin Feige.
You and Tom Holland, bro. Get the fuck out of here, bro.
But honestly, Alex is not wrong that Sony needs to announce Spider-Man 4, like, yesterday. I don't know what's going on with that.
Yeah, you got to bring the big guns, bro, for this movie.
But that's Sony, though. Sony needs to announce that, like yesterday. I don't know what's happening with that movie, dude. That's not good. That needs to come out before Doomsday.
Sony's
this is not good.
Sony's about to get bought out, bro, by Disney.
Well, then I don't even buy it, Disney.
Because what do you got next? Venom and Kraven?
Kraven got delayed to next year. Remember
exactly,
that?
Exactly, bro. Are you kidding me?
Like, it's been done for a really
long time.
And
Venom is
Kraven.
Venom is titled The Last Dance. Could this be the last?
Ironically,
because
it's the last movie.
Please, God. The last movie in general from Sonyverse. I hope this is like, they just like sell it off at that point.
I think they want to, but they want to keep getting paid. And anytime they do a Spider-Man movie, they're going to get paid. I just feel like Disney should just pay it out.
I better get my Spider-Verse 3, though. Stop it.
Yeah. Yeah, that we need. They can keep it. The animation, bro. Sony Animation, Marvel. Go ahead, do that. Do that thing.
Do their thing, man. Then sell
do
it off.
Venom. Venom across the Venomverse. I don't care. Just do something.
No.